Last night was fun. Well, you're going to get to have more fun today, but we're also going to try to make your head hurt a little bit. I feel like that's part of our responsibilities. You are also at a literal crossroads. If you think about it, right next door we have buyers and sellers meeting. That's what, you know, you go back 1,200 years before Constantinople became Constantinople, buyers and sellers met where two roads crossed. We have all the iconic, symbolic, and archetypal reference associated to crossroads. The Baal Shem Tov, a 16th century rabbi who was given credit for inventing Kabbalah, the metaphysics of Judaism, when asked, how do you tell a true prophet? Said, beware of the person who comes with the answers. Listen to the person who comes with the questions. You'll have the answers yourself. And our job is to stimulate you in that way. So with that, let me do my little piece here before I get into the fun introductions. And let's start with, let's face it, this is why we're at a crossroads. If things are so great, why do I feel so bad? There's a gnawing in our guts of knowing that things just aren't necessarily the way we perceive them. I like to call this cultural schizophrenia. And cultural schizophrenia is the modern condition born of the discrimination between attitudes and behaviors, between the way the world presents itself and the way that we intuit it to be. We're in effect living in a time that I like to call an abolition of context. The only context today is that there is none. You know, the blurring of the difference between right and wrong. The fact that there's no authority in the world. When I was a kid, if you asked who was the world's most well-known rocket scientist, anyone who answered, which would have been the majority of the people, would have said Wernher von Braun. It's impossible to say that today. I mean, how else can you explain that Ozzy Osbourne's become a poster child for fatherhood? In effect, the driving principle we have to deal with is paradox. How we have both the threats of one side and the opportunities on the other side's making their own crossroads. How, interestingly, as an industry, we still have people with paste and paper in the dark ages while we're on the bleeding edge of bringing technology in. You know, the two biggest categories of book sales in America are diet books and cookbooks to the same people. The great paradox for us, of course, is the paradox of risk. Today, in the world as we see it, you can't afford not to take it. You can't afford, and this is what the crossroads gets us to. What are the new business models that we have to play with? How do we participate in all of these new things that are being driven by what I like to call a new social agenda organized by self-organization? Self-selecting social mechanization is our future. It's not just about innovation. It's about creation, it's about invention, and there's five pillars to all creation. And the first of those five pillars is called scope. You've got to give yourself permission to think 10x. And you have to understand what you're curious about, what people are curious about, what your employees are curious about. You know, so what are we as an industry curious about? We have to remember that there's nothing more important than attention to detail in creation. And in that way, Thomas Edison did feed Jack Welch on Six Sigma, because he tried 7,000 different elements before he got one that made the light bulb. And we have to challenge convention. I don't mind admitting I'm a bit of a deviant, but all great ideas usually come from just being a little outside of somebody's definition of what is normal. And finally, you have to include play, fun. 70% of everything you learn in life is through play. Why we separated those two things at the Industrial Revolution, I have no clue, but they're starting to come back. Because what's great for us as an industry, for you as an industry, is that home is no longer a location. Home is a concept. And that means there will eventually be no difference between in-home and out-of-home as a delineator of your industry, in my opinion. So I ask us to remember what Albert Einstein taught us. I love Einstein, you know. The degree of thinking that gets you into a problem is never the same degree that will get you out of a problem.